¿Qué tal,
No.
mamá? Allillanchu kashanki.
Allí
Ahora sí, mamá, nispaka kallariursun, chesha imaman tarimanki kunan.
y me tan roba con chuño moraya.
Allí. Okay, though our dear Karina will speak about the techniques of dehydration of food. In this case, specifically, she's going to talk about the dehydration of the potatoes. Okay, so she will start. She made a beautiful PowerPoint presentation, which I will share. Am I co-host, Elizabeth?
You are.
All right, then I'm going to share and she's going to start with her explanation. Okay. Karinita, todo tuyo, mamá. Háblanos. Tú dime cuando tenga que pasar la diapositiva a la otra.
Yeah. We don't see any yet.
Sure.
But, ¿en quechua o en español?
Okay, just a minute, please. En español, mamá, en español hablas y yo voy a traducir. Hold on, please. Un momentito, mamá. Okay, then. Compartir pantalla. Compartir. Can you see now? Yeah, everybody can see.
Yes.
Wonderful. Okay. ¿Hablas en español o en quechua, mami? Y si puedes hablar en inglés, mejor. Si no, en quechua o en español, yo traduzco.
Yeah. En español voy a hablar.
Excelente. Habla, mamá, habla.
Ya.
Karinita, lo que sale de tu corazón, lo que sale de tu corazón, lo que sabes, así, solo lo que sabes, no hay ningún problema. Así, todo bien, lo que sale de tu corazoncito nomás, ¿ya?
Buenas tardes, hermanos y hermanas. En esta oportunidad les voy a dar a conocer cómo se hace el chuño y la moraya.
My brothers and sisters, at this opportunity, I will let you know how we dehydrate the potatoes and how we make chuño and moraya. I hope you will love it.
Oh.
Wow.
Yeah. Aquí tenemos el chuño. El chuño es un alimento que se procesa de la papa. Y el chuño se realiza en los meses de mayo, junio y julio. Uh-huh. El chuño también, primeramente les voy a decir de qué. Algunos se preguntarán cómo se hace el chuño. Mis compatriotas mismos se preguntaron cómo se realiza el chuño. ¿Crece o se hace? Yo les digo, ¿cómo va a crecer? El chuño se hace de la papa. Siguiente diapositiva, por favor.
Okay, so, Karina says, like, to all people, it's quite weird when you present your chuño, okay, the chuño, when you give it to them, okay, and then they say, how you grow chuño? Karina says, no, you don't grow chuño. You grow potatoes and then you dehydrate the potatoes and you get chuño afterwards. Okay, so this is for people that doesn't know that. So mainly the prime material is potatoes and demands that it's usually done. It is in May, June, and July, which is our extreme dry season and it's our cold period. Ya lo pasé.
Primero se para. Primero, para hacer el chuño, se selecciona la papa según el tamaño y el tipo. El tamaño sería si es grande, mediano y pequeño. el tipo de papa son las más amargas, como son el cusi, pucaparco y el yurasparco. Depende a eso se hace el chuño.
Okay, so chuño, first you have to select the potatoes amongst the big one, the medium one, and the small one. Okay, not all potatoes are candidate to be dehydrated. They have a special potatoes that they choose for dehydrating, which mainly are the sour potatoes. Okay, in this case, they have the cusi, okay, the tipo is the type, cusi, pucaparco, yaparco, and amahaya. So are the four types of potatoes that are the ones that they dehydrate. And remember, have to be the sour potatoes.
Or bitter? Is it amargo?
Or bitter. The bitter potatoes. Gracias, Elizabeth. Thank you very much. Merci beaucoup. Yeah. Siguiente, mami.
Siguiente diapositiva, por favor.
Okay.
También se debe tener en cuenta las condiciones climáticas en los meses que son de mayo y junio. Tienen que esperar la helada para hacer el chuño. Para que el chuño salga bien. Y luego se prepara la base con la paja. Se hace un redondo en un círculo, lo prepara la paja para que ahí puedan poner el chuño. En la papa, diré.
Ok.
Después de eso.
Sigue, hija, sigue.
Después de eso lo moldean bonito así y lo hacen la papa los seleccionados lo ponen en cada lugar donde va a ir la papa. Y nosotros los que somos de Quero, nosotros el chuño y la papa, el chuño para que esté bien, lo ponen en orden cada uno, seleccionando las papas grandes en círculo, toditito las papitas. Ordenaditos. Bien ordenaditos para que la helada lo agarre rápido.
Ajá. Okay. So, you know, an important part of this process needs to be the climate conditions. Not every place in Peru can do this process of dehydration. Okay, this is something that you done only at the highlands where the weather is so extreme in terms of frost. Okay, like say in the Sacred Valley of Cusco, okay, which is like 200 kilometers away or 200 kilometers away from Queros, you can't do that. It's impossible because we don't have frost there. So it needs to be places where the temperature drops down below zero, like 10 to 15 Celsius. Okay, so in Queros, they have that chance. They have that opportunity. And they are a potato farmers. So those are two aspects that we have to be aware. Not everywhere you can do this. Number one, the climate conditions. The second thing it is, they have to look for a big fields and then they have to make a kind of path on the fields with a straw. So the straw, you have to make like a little rug. Okay, and then you have to put in order, okay, you have to have a good order, the big potatoes, the medium potatoes, and the small potatoes. What they do, they make a kind of a uniform way to to put the potatoes on the straw, okay? Only for the big ones, the small ones, and the medium ones. You cannot mix medium, small, or big ones in ones. Have to be same size. That it's going to facilitate to the frost, you know, arrive each potato, okay? To each of them, you know, you will be uniform. And what they do, it's mainly they put the potatoes on these straw rags, you know, in a circles, okay? They make circles, they expand in a uniform way, and the frost wheat will arrive to each of them. Siguiente, mami.
Sí, siguiente.
Perfect.
Después de preparar la paja, lo extienden toda la papa por toda la parte en donde está. Encima de la paja, lo ponen bien ordenaditos. En su posición cada uno, como podemos ver en las imágenes, en forma de redondos, para que la helada pueda coger más rápido. Las papas más grandes son los que demoran en que coger la helada. Y las papas medianas no demoran tanto tiempo como la papa grande. Y a los que les agarra más rápido la helada son a las papas pequeñas. Para que esté todo, para que agarre bien la helada, nosotros lo volteamos la papa para que nos facilite y lo hagamos en menos tiempo, el chuño. Lo volteamos la papa y lo hacemos.
Okay. Okay, so the process of making the chuño, okay, the chuño or the black dehydrated potato chuño, okay, the process is shorter for the small potatoes. It's medium shorter, medium time, okay, like less time. Okay, what am I saying? It's longer time to big potatoes, medium time for medium potatoes, and short time for smaller potatoes. Because the frost will get to the smaller potatoes easier, but not to the big ones. It is why, okay, they work mainly with medium and small potatoes, and the big ones, yeah, they don't really do as much. So as they take more time, but they have a technique, you know, to make it faster. How come? It is they turn the potatoes, you know, if the frost caught to the top face and then they turn opposite down, you know, like making the frost catch to that part, hidden part as well. Okay, so this is an extra job that they do. Sigue, mami.
Yeah, la siguiente diapositiva. Yeah, después de 2 semanas, después de haber hecho todo este proceso, nosotros conocemos el chuñusarui, en donde pisamos todos los chuños, para pelarlo.
Yeah.
Y pisamos hasta que queden blanquitas las papas, el chuño.
Ya.
Yeah. Y eso tiene que hacerse todo. Más lo hacen en las papas grandes que en las papas pequeñas, en queros.
¿Y por qué las pequeñas no?
Es que rápido agarra y se pela rapidito. Por eso no lo hacen mucho, ajá. Y las papas grandes, si lo pisamos hasta que lo pelemos, ajá, su cascarita, y la helada más rápido lo coge. Y después de vuelta lo ponemos en ordencito toda la papa, en un redondo.
Veo que también sale agua de la papa, ¿es cierto eso?
Sí, es lo que la helada le agarra, por eso pisamos ahí. Y ese proceso también se llama choñoqueta.
Ah, ya. Okay, so, you know, after the potatoes has been exposed to the frost, yeah, after all this was exposed to the frost, then obviously the potato, you know, created a lot of blisters, you know, the skin holds the water. After these 2 weeks, then they go into the process of chuño sarui, which literally means the chuño, step on the chuño. Elizabeth, can you help me? It's just like when you step on it, it's because you need to press to explode the blister.
Just like pressing, like stepping on the grapes to make the wine.
Exactly.
Potatoes to squeeze out the
exactly. Liquid. Squeeze the liquid and at the same time peel the potato, because when the blister explodes, also the skin of the potato comes out. See, this is a process that they do mainly to the big potatoes, okay? The medium ones and the small ones does themselves, you know, the process is easier in that one. So in the bigger potatoes, they have to step like this, okay, with the tire sandals. I can see, oh my gosh, that must be very cold to do, you know. And yeah, you take the water out and you take the skin out. Also to that process they call as the chuño sarui or the chuño queta, you know.
Chuño sarui?
No, sarui. It's written in the slide. It's chuño sarui. Yeah.
Got it. Nice. Can I ask a question?
Yep.
Is it also the heat? Is it a freeze dry? Is it the cold at night and the heat during the day, those two processes that work together from the potato, or only the frost?
Karinita, ¿tiene que ver algo el sol para el proceso de el chuño?
¿El sol?
O, ya, ¿tiene que ver el sol o solo? A ver, cuéntanos entonces.
Sí, sí, también tiene que ver el sol. Cuando hay sol, el chuño se hace más amargo. Se hace más amargo cuando caen los rayos solares.
¿Y eso es conveniente o es inconveniente?
Es conveniente porque... porque así el chuño se hace más rico, pero si vas a comer el chuño queta, para eso sí no es conveniente, porque va a salir agrio.
Ah.
Porque hay algunas personas que, por ejemplo, nosotros nos cocinamos eso, cuando está en medio proceso, nos hacemos sopa de chuño queta, sí. Ajá. Ah. Y seleccionamos los que están, los que ya agarró la helada.
Ah. Ah, ajá. Ya, como papa helada.
Papelada, lo comemos.
Ajá. Okay. So, for the process of the chuño, it's important that the sunrise comes and, you know, irrigates its heat there for the chuño. But if you do chuño queta, you know, what's that? Chuño queta, it is the medium process. It's the potato that has been caught by the frost, but it's not dry because they need to the sun to dry it up and make it like a little stone, yeah? So for the process of the chuño, yes, the sun, it's very important. But to the process of chuño queta, which is only the medium process, is not good because that make it bitter and they don't like it. Because the medium process, it is very, very good and very delicious to have a potato soup. You know, they really love doing the potato soup when it's in the medium process. But if they want to do the chuño, of course, they have to put it in the sun. Gives this particular flavor, which is a little bit bitter, you know, to the chuño, which is very nice. You know, we love it. You know, all those who grew up on chuño, then we like the bitter chuño. So Karina says that, of course, for chuño, the sun, it's very important. They like it. ¿Ya, mami? ¿Algo más?
Sí. Eso sería todo.
Ya, siguiente diapositiva entonces.
Ajá, siguiente. El chuño al final se esperamos a que se seque todo. El chuño demora más secando que la moraya. Se demora como un mes así para el secado del chuño. Y cada vez tienen que ir a ver el chuño, si está, voltearlo para que seque más rápido. Y máximo sí demora un mes el secado, así volteándolo, viéndolo cómo está, todo eso. Uh-huh. Los que más demoran van a ser los chuños grandes que los pequeños. Y los medianos más demoran ese tiempo.
Perfecto.
Y para recogerlo, todos lo amontonan el chuño para llevar y hacen un seleccionado donde van a estar los chuños que ya están sequitos y los chuños que falta secar todavía para que de vuelta lo hagan secar. Y los que están sequitos lo guardan ya. Y los que no, lo ponen en otro lugar para que puedan estar secando. Porque en allá, como vemos, no, el clima es variado. Por eso hay veces no seca tan rápido ahí.
Okay, so Karina says that the dehydration of the potato would take at least 1 month. Okay, 1 month, because the difficulty over there in Queros, it is the weather condition, because even though, you know, they have the dry season, still the humidity comes from the jungle and it's not allowing to the chuño dry quick right away. It is why they have to wait, you know, to all this process at least 1 month. So when they are drying, okay, they have to be always aware they have to choose which ones are dry, which ones are medium dry, or which ones are wet yet. Okay, so they have to start selecting, okay? So they have to keep it, the dry ones. When it's ready, they have to take it home, and then they have to select the medium dry and the wet ones. So this is the process, how they go. They don't wait until all of them are dry, because, you know, with the weather condition, you can damage also to the dry ones if you are waiting, all right? So, yes. So Karina says that it's a long period of time, at least 1 month, you know, to dry it up. Sigue, mami.
Yeah. El chuño pesa mucho para que cuando lo llevan así, pesa más que la papa, digamos, porque una cantidad de necesito pesa demasiado cuando llevas a tu casa, así. Cuando lo cargué yo, pesaba demasiado que no podía ni recoger el chuño.
Okay. So, when you have the chuño, okay, you have a very small potato, okay, very small, like a little stone. Exactly, it is like that. This is why Karina says, like, when you put in a sack, okay, the chuño weighs more, than a sack of regular potato, okay, that you just harvested, you know? How come? Because it's more amount of potatoes in there, are tinier, but then are heavier. So to transport, you have to make in a small sacks because you cannot carry a big loads. Yeah. Sigue, Karinita.
La siguiente diapositiva sería todo el proceso del chuño.
Okay.
Ahora vamos a explicar sobre cómo se hace la muralla.
Okay. ¿Cuál es la diferencia entre el chuño y la muralla? Ya, yeah, okay, te dejo, okay.
La muralla, cuando está en el proceso, se llama joto. No se dice muralla siempre. Joto se llama. Como sabemos, cada uno, primeramente también vamos a seleccionar la papa, que son más convenientes hacerlo con las papas de Mantaro, Mariahuanca, Ruki, y el Winco y el Yunkai. Esas son las papas que con qué más hacemos en allá, en la muralla. Y son más preferibles. Y después lo hacemos igual que al chuño, lo preparamos la base con la paja para que podamos ponerle la papa y todo. Los seleccionamos, los pequeños, grandes y todo eso. Los pequeños redondos van a ser más de las papas pequeñas y los redondos grandes van a ser de las papas grandes más. En esta diapositiva sería todo eso.
Okay, so then we have the other technique of dehydration of potatoes, which we know as moraya, okay? But in Eros, they call koto. You know, it's koto. It's koto, no es koto.
No.
Okay. Okay. Then they call koto. Okay. That's the name in Eros of the moraya. Okay. So the process at the first part of the process is quite about the same as the chuño, but with the difference that they use another varieties of potatoes. Okay, in this case, they prefer to do moraya or koto from the Mantaro variety of potato, Mariahuanca, Ruki, Winco, and Yunkai. Yeah, oh my gosh, I don't think you will be able to do it. Chuño or moraya, because you don't have the varieties of potatoes. It's a lot, you know, only for one lesson. Gracias, mami. Espera un momento. Okay, then you choose this and you do the same as you did for the chuño, okay? You, in this case, you do the medium and the big ones, okay? By some reason, she did a name to a small one, medium and big ones, and they choose the same, the big ones in the big load, the small ones in the small load. Okay, though they put it in the straw carpet. Yeah, mami.
Yeah. Estas papas que he mencionado son especialmente para morayas. No se puede consumir porque es agria al momento de consumir esas papas. Por ejemplo, la mariahuanca, cuando quieres consumirlo así, va a ser agria, vas a sentir que es agria, no va a ser como la papa. Por eso son estas papas son especialmente para la moraya.
Perfecto. Okay. These varieties of potatoes are farmed exclusively for moraya. Okay, they don't farm these to eat, because if you commit to eat the Mantaro, Mariahuanca, Ruki, Winco, or Yungay potato, you want to eat right away when you harvest, then it's bitter. You won't like it. This is exclusively farmed for the moraya process.
So, Freddie, I don't get what the difference is, Moraya and Chuño. Is only a different name because it's a different kind of potato, but you do exactly the same thing?
Okay. Possibly she will arrive to that. Yeah. If not, I am getting your question, okay? Okay. Possibly in the following lessons, we will let us know the difference, okay? ¿Siguiente diapositiva, mami?
Sí, siguiente diapositiva.
Perfecto.
Mira, después de preparar la base con la paja, en la tarde se pone la papa encima de la paja. Ya en la tarde esto se hace como a las 5 o 4, a esas horas se pone, para que la helada pueda agarrarla. Solo que en acá no se hace como el chuño, sino que después de en la amanecida se recoge en montoncitos antes de que el sol llegue. No puede verlo el sol, sino se hace como el chuño negro. Por eso es que las personas van rápido, corren en la mañanita, se levantan temprano y tienen que ir a hacer eso. Y lo amontonan rápido de muchos.
Okay. There we go. Mm-hmm. Okay, so the process is the same. In the afternoon, you are going to expand it and then you are going to expose this to to the frost, okay? Because in the Andes, sorry. Like in the places where they perform or they do the chuño and moraya, mainly the frost is late in the afternoon, the whole night and early in the morning, okay? So for making the moraya, you do the same as for the chuño. You expand, you expose it to the frost, but early in the morning, before the sun rises, you have to pick it up because you won't allow this potato to be exposed to the sun. Otherwise, it's going to become chuño, okay? So for moraya, you have to pick it up, you have to make just in rows like this, and you have to cover that the sun won't catch to this one.
Yeah, and aquí también hay personas que esto lo repiten 2 veces o 3 veces, lo hacen lo mismo, lo extienden y en las mañanitas lo tapan con el chusi y debes repetir. Yo he repetido 2 veces en haciendo eso, lo amontono en la mañana, vengo a recogerlo y lo tapo con el chusi para que el sol no le pueda caer y no lo queme como al chuño.
Yeah. ¿Y matagri chusiri?
¿Chusi?
Ajá.
Es la frazada que hacen ellos. Para nosotros es frazada. Nosotros tejemos. Ajá.
Ya, yeah. Perfecto. Ok. So, this process you have to repeat 2 or 3 times. Ok, 2 or 3 times. The experience of Karina, you know, is that when she made moraya at her house in Eros, she did 2 times, but people sometimes do 3 times this, okay? Exposed to the frost early in the morning, just gather it and cover it with the chusi. And what is the chusi? Those are special weavings that they do, like, you know, like a blanket, to cover it, to not pick it up and put in a sack. You know, you just, you know, gather the whole thing, gather when it's expanded, you just gather it again and you cover it with the blanket. So the sun is not catching. So she did 2 times that process. Llámame.
En el siguiente sería. Ya. Después de haber hecho todo ese proceso, recurrimos al kotosari. De vuelta hacemos, o pisamos ahí, zapateamos ahí, al koto. Porque no se dice moraya todavía, se dice koto. Y sacamos, lo pelamos así con el pie, pisándolo. Todo lo que hemos hecho. Todo lo que está seleccionado para la muralla. Después de sí. eso, después de eso vemos, hacemos en Queros, tienen cada uno su pozo, su pocito, así redondito. Como pueden ver en la imagen, en ahí primero hacen un hoyo grande y lo meten primero la paja debajo. Y después de eso, la moraya en la mañana lo echan. Diré, el joto lo echan, dependiendo a cuánto alcance. Estos hoyitos hacen como cuatro así. Uña cochachacuna lo dicen allá. Y encima lo tapan con la paja y lo ponen piedras. Eso hacen este. Eso sería.
Okay, so the next part of the process of making koto or moraya is the koto sarui. Sarui, it is the action of stepping in something, okay, pressing with your foot, yeah? So koto sarui, as you can see, you know, they do in a bare foot. So they have to peel, you know, the skin of the koto in this case. Okay, and then for the following pace, they make a small ponds of water. Okay, a small ponds. Each family will make like three, four ponds of water. And then they put it a straw in the vase. Okay, they put a straw in the vase. You make your water well or your water pond. In the base, you put it with a straw, and then you damp the whole koto there, and you cover once again with a straw, and you press with the stones.
Wait, the potatoes go in the pond?
Yeah, yes.
Potatoes go in the water?
In the water.
Okay.
¿Chaimantani, mami?
Esto lo dejan por unas 2 semanas así. Lo está ahí dentro del pocito.
Uh-huh.
Eso nomás sería en esta diapositiva.
Okay. Then, you know, the koto stays in the water pond, in the water well, okay? For 2 weeks, more or less. Yeah, like as I told you, okay? They made the water well, straw in the vase, potatoes in there, in the water, covered with a straw and pressed with potatoes, I mean with stones for 2 weeks.
Esto lo hacen para que pueda pasar el agua. Después de una semana, 2 semanas, Lo sacan cada, en saquitos lo sacan con la mano en la mañana y de vuelta lo extienden para que pueda secarse.
Uh-huh.
Ajá, ahí podemos ver en la imagen que están sacando la moraya ya blanquita, no es como el chuño yeah. Es negrito, pero la moraya por lo que ha pasado en el agua se hace así blanquito.
Ajá. Y Karina, y también tú crees que
luego se extiende por
Karinita, y también me puedes decir el motivo por la cual le meten al agua por 2 semanas, ¿tú crees que también sea para sacarle el amargor de la papa? Por eso es que la moraya no es amarga como el chuño. Tú me dirás si eso puede ser cierto.
Sí, eso también es cierto, porque esto, la moraya lo meten al agua para que pueda ser blanquito y no como el chuño negrito. Con esa finalidad lo hacen.
Ah, perfecto. Okay, so there we go. The difference amongst Chuño and Moraya is the fact that Chuño is black, okay? And Moraya is white. We have seen through the process that is completely different. Only the beginning, it is the same, but then the second step and the third and the fourth step is different because in the process of Coto or Moraya, there is no exposition to the sun at the beginning. Okay, they have to hide it. Okay, and after they do for 2 weeks that, they put again, you know, all this in the water, which Karina says it is for keeping the potato white. And also she agrees that it is for taking the bitter out of the potato. Because all those who eats Moraya or Coto and Chuño, Chuño it's bitter. It has its own way to cook and eat, but Moraya is not bitter at all. So that would be the two reasons why, you know, why this process it's involved, water in and the other one not. So after these 2 weeks, they take this out of the water well and they expand all to the sun, okay? And then, you know, have it the Moraya, which is these very nice and beautiful white dehydrated potatoes.
Wow. do they put the Chuño and the Moraya in the Jaguariqui? I have never seen that.
Karinita, ¿alguna vez viste si se pone Chuño o Moraya en el Jaguariqui o en el despacho? Tú, si tú viste, no, no solamente si tú viste. Ajá. Si alguna vez viste.
Bueno, yo
no.
No. No he visto. Okay.
She haven't seen. She haven't seen her experience. I said, like, if you personally experience sometime that Chuño or Moraya goes in the offering in the Jaguariqui or despacho, she says not. If you ask me that question, I would say also no. I've never seen Chuño or Moraya going into the Jaguariqui.
It's interesting, right, Freddy? Because that's such a food.
Very interesting. Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Siguiente
okay.
Diapositiva.
Sí, siguiente.
Wow.
Y al final se espera el secado de la Moraya, que seca más rápido que el Chuño. El Chuño es el que va a demorar más secando. La Moraya rapidito seca. No se demora tanto como el Chuño. Una semana, sí, ya está seco, no como el Chuño, que demora un mes, así. Rapidito seca. Los más grandes son los que van a demorar también más. Y los pequeñitos, rapidito seca. Y así, okay. Como vemos, lo amontonan. Lo amontonan y lo ponen en sacos y también hacen la selección de los que están bien sequitos y los que no han secado todavía.
Okay, then the last part of the process is the same as the Chuño. But the experience of Karina is that Chuño dries longer and Moraya dries in a shorter period of time. So sometimes it's only 1 week needed for drying the Chuño, okay? And then they do the same process. You know, the bigger one is picked up and kept at last, and the smaller ones are first because they are easier and faster drying, and then they keep it. Karinita,
¿sí?
¿El Chuño o la Moraya cuesta más caro?
¿Más caro?
Ajá. ¿Cuál cuesta más caro? Si yo quiero comprar 1 kilo de Moraya o 1 kilo de Chuño, ¿cuál de los dos me cuesta más caro?
La moraya, porque la moraya, su proceso es un poco más larguito que el chuño. El chuño solo se extiende en la pampa y lo pones, pero la moraya tiene que pasar por el proceso de estar en el pocito por una semana, sacarlo, y por eso cuesta más la moraya.
Okay, so my question was if chuño or coto or moraya costs more in the market, if I would like to buy. So she says that moraya is more expensive because the process is more tedious, okay? The fact that you have to wake up very early, you know, to gather it and not let it exposed to the sun and cover it and then put it in the water, make the water wells, put a straw, cover with the stones and all this. So it takes, it's more process rather than chuño is only just, you know, put in to the frost and the sun. Any question, anyone, please go ahead. If we have questions, Elizabeth has one question. Elizabeth tiene una pregunta.
Siempre. Soy hecho de pregunta. Okay. When you said you separate the sizes, so is that each circle has a different size? Like all the small ones are in one circle and all the medium sized ones are in one circle and all the big ones are in one circle? Is that how you, how they're organized?
Yes, that's what she said. Yeah. Okay. Big ones with big ones, medium ones only with medium ones, small ones only with small ones.
Okay. Cool.
That is just, that is to make uniform the process.
Yeah. You know,
just to make it all uniform the process. It is why also they do 3 or 4 water wells. Okay, when you do the moraya, because one water well, it's for the big ones, the second for the medium, and then for the smaller ones. Chaymantari, chaymantari, Karinita, imakunatawan niwan kichisman.
El chuño y la moraya, la diferencia es que es el chuño es negrito, como pueden ver, acá tengo una muestra. No sé si van a poder ver. Como pueden ver, esto es negro. Negrito.
Ajá.
Y la moraya, blanquito.
Ajá.
Esa es la diferencia. Y la moraya es más arenosa que el chuño. Y tiene una textura de negrito cuando lo comes así. Bueno, en la moraya, el chuño lo comen más en queros que la moraya, digamos. Siempre el chuño lo encuentras en todo. Y la moraya más hacen para fiambres, para que vayan a pastear sus ovejas, sus llamas, para eso.
Which one do you like better, Karina?
Karina, ¿cuál de los dos te gusta más?
La moraya.
Okay, this is why I will tell you why, you know, a lot of people prefers moraya rather than chuño, but I mean, this is the difference. Well, to begin, Karina says the difference among chuño and moraya. Chuño is black, okay, and moraya is white, okay, and each of them has different way of usage at home. So chuño regularly you find in a warm meal, okay, in a soups, you know, in, yeah, all warm, that's what you eat, you know, for your lunch or dinner, but it's for a warm food, okay. But moraya is mainly for a snack. You take it when you go alpaca herding, when you go and work, you know, in your field, you know, you can eat it also cold, okay? Another, it's not sour. Third, it is starchy, you know? It's a little starchy, yeah? And to the question, which one you like more? Karina says, I like more moraya. Of course, because always, when you go working in a farm, it's the only thing you eat, and this is always delicious. Yeah, this is what I like too. Moraya, I love Moraya. You know, just to tell you, you know, my mother-in-law does Moraya cut in half, and she put cheese in there, and she steams, just steamed Moraya, you know, stuffed with cheese. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. That's the most delicious thing you could get. And that's for breakfast.
I'm getting hungry, Freddie. I'm getting hungry.
Oh yeah, of course. I'm hungry already.
You're making me hungry.
Mm. Siguiente diapositiva, mami.
Sí, creo que es todo. Gracias, oh. Espero que les haga la exposición.
Wow.
Oh, Karinita, she says, like, I hope you loved the exposition. I hope you love the presentation.
Beautiful.
Karinita.
Felicitaciones, Karinita. Felicitaciones. Muy
Gracias.
Bien, muy bonito.
Gracias a ustedes por darme esta oportunidad de poner este proceso de
Thank
la Moraya
you.
Y el Chuño.
Thank you by letting me present the process of the Chuño and the Moraya for you. Thank you.
Fue un gusto hablar sobre este proceso y que ustedes también puedan conocer cómo se hace esto. El
Chuño. So she likes doing all this. She's part of her life. She likes doing the process of the Chuño and the Moraya, and I hope you learned as well. And just to add, my beautiful family, all those who are in this very nice and wonderful, amazing lessons of how to make Chuño and Moraya, I will tell you, this was one of the most important economical activities of the Inca people, which the Jero people preserved. You know why? Because this is the way how they transported potatoes to the place where they never farmed, like the Pacific coast. You know, dehydrated potatoes, you know, you take as much potatoes, okay? And then you arrive to the coast, you hydrate again, and this never lost its nutrition facts. People from the coast loved it because they didn't have the chance to grow potatoes, all right? But they were fish farmers, though the Andean people from the highlands took massive amount of potatoes in 100 and 200 llamas, and they used to bring a lot of fish and salt from there to the highlands, though this was one of the, you know, most important activities that the Inca people did, you know, for a very organic economical organization. Also, the coastal people knew how to dehydrate the fish, you know, to bring it into the highlands. Amazing. The Inca people, thanks to these processes, they have, you know, They were self-sufficient, you know, in feeding to the whole Inca Empire on all kinds of meats, all kinds of tubercles, and all kinds of grains spread into the Inca Kingdom, you know, in the right way, using the Inca trails. Yes, wonderful.
And is it true, Freddie, that they found a 500-year-old Chuño in a grave that was still good to eat? I read this somewhere in an article. They found a Chuño.
Definitely, you know, if the scientists found, then they are going to make the biochemic tests. And if they find, you know, the nutrition facts, it'll be ready to eat. In fact, they won't eat because then 500-year-old Chuño is a treasure. They have to keep it. But would be ready to eat, you know? Mm-hmm. And that, yes. But the Chuño, you can keep, you know, like in my community, we used to keep over 2, 3, or 4 years, you know? And then we just hydrated again, eat it, and then, you know, the nutrition facts were the same as the first month. That's for sure.
Amazing. Amazing. And also you hear the story of all of the food in the storehouses of the Inca, yeah? And that there was enough food that had been gathered that fed the Spanish armies for like 50 years after they conquered the Incas.
Yep.
Or something like that, some crazy amount of time.
In reality, the Inca people, so as the Jero people, you know, keep this wisdom, all right? They have their storehouses full of dehydrated food for their critic periods, because nowadays, you know, we are scared about the Niño, for by instance. El Niño is the climate change that we have in Peru mainly, that happens every 7 and 15 years. They are called El Niño, La Niña, El Super Niño. You know, scientists nowadays knows when this happens. But the Inca people, perhaps they didn't have this technology. But what these people did is only, you know, wait for these critical periods to come. And they knew that they were coming like every 5, 7, 15 years. And they had their storehouses full of chuño, full of dehydrated seeds and all this. And they never cared. If the Niño comes, it's okay. We are just going to be indoors. We are going to prepare some chicha and it'll go. It's okay. We have enough food. Okay. So they were self-sufficient in it. They were not, you know, a kind of fear that we have nowadays, you know. Oh my gosh, no. They communicated with nature.
They were prepared. Excellent. Wow, Karina, qué bien. Qué bonito tu presentación. Muy lindo. Excelente. Muchísimas gracias.
Espero que les haya agradado
mi posición. Añay panay, sumaj, mamá, munay. Nishumunay. Entonces, ahora yo soy. Because she's white, I am black. All right, never mind. I think. My sense of humor is not nice.
You're a chuño, Freddy.
Yep.
Okay, muy bien. Are there any other questions for Karina?
Is it, when you buy it on the market, is it much more expensive than normal potatoes?
Karina, en el mercado la papa regular es cuesta sí. Igual o el chuño y moraya cuesta más caro.
El chuño y la moraya cuesta un poquito caro, digamos. La papa no cuesta. Porque el chuño y la moraya son procesados. Mientras que la papa no.
Okay,
no,
so
no.
As every process. Yeah. Okay, as all processed food, you know, it's more expensive, though she says that chuño and moraya are more expensive than the regular potatoes.
And you do this process once a year? During May, June, and July for both kinds of potatoes.
Exactly. Yeah, it's only. So she says you do in May, June, and July only. Once a year. Our extreme dry season and frost period of time.
So do the Quero bring them to the market or do they just use them only for their own food? Only for in Queros?
¿Ustedes preparan también para vender o solo es para vuestro consumo?
Nosotros solo preparamos para el consumo. No vendemos, pero hay algunas personas que sí lo hacen, pero son la minoría, no tanto nosotros.
Okay. So the question
nosotros
was
todo lo que hacemos en nosotros todo lo que hacemos en Keras es para nosotros, no para sobrevivencia de nosotros, no para venderlo así. La papa, ya sea la papa, el chuño, la moraya, todo eso. Maíz. Eso es lo que más producimos en Eros.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so everything that they do in Eros is only for their own consumption, okay? Just it's a very few people that does for selling. But it's mainly for their own.
For their self-sufficient life. Karina, exactly. During COVID, did you spend more time in Keros than in Cusco over this last year and a half?
Mm-hmm. Karina, durante la temporada de COVID, durante la temporada de COVID, ¿has estado más en Keros o has estado en Cusco?
He estado en Keros casi por un año. Por eso todo eso he aprendido.
¡Wow!
Sí, y mucho he experimentado. Sí.
She has been in Keros improving her skills of, potato dehydrator.
So if not for COVID, a lot of the kids in Keros would not have spent the last year they live in Cusco. They went back to Keros because it was so much better during COVID to be in Keros where they could be outside and have all their own food and their animals. And in Cusco, it was more difficult because everyone was locked in their houses. So a lot of them went back and a lot of the kids are now saying, oh, we like it better in Keros. Super interesting, right? What do you like better, Keros or Cusco, Karina?
Keros.
¿Así?
Sí.
¿Por qué?
Porque en allá es más abierto, más libre, más bonito. No es cerrado como en la ciudad. Y es todo natural, en ahí solo hacen para sobrevivir ellos nomás, no se preocupan por los demás.
Ajá. Más relajado la vida.
Sí, más relajado. Dios. Mm. Más en allá más se preocupan por cosechar la papa, todo eso. No es como en la ciudad que se preocupan por los estudios y todo eso. En allá solo se preocupan por la sobrevivencia. Y estar ahí con los ganados, hacer la cosecha. Y para los carnavales, tejen y todo eso.
Uh-huh. Wow.
Sí, yo también he experimentado muchas cosas en allá en 2020. Aprendí muchas cosas que no sabía hacer. Wow. Por ejemplo, el chuño y la moraya, yo también hice. Me costó un poco, pero aprendí. Día a día, ay, arreando las alpacas, las llamas. Me acostumbré a vivir allá.
Wow.
Sí.
So she likes better being in Eros because, you know, the activity is only, it's self-sufficient. It's just for, they are worried only of just surviving the day, the month, and the year. It's not as much worries there. They are just behind the animals, harvesting, weaving, getting ready for some festivity, you know? And for Karina, it was very important, the experience there this last year. It's because she learned to do more things, so as the dehydration of potatoes, because she was part of this process. You know, so she learned more things in the last year.
Things she didn't know how to do before. Yeah. And it was a little hard, a little bit of a struggle.
That's why she said she learned.
But she made the effort and she learned. Nice.
Yep.
And she says it's more beautiful, more open there. You're in the nature is beautiful, not like in the city. Are you there, Melanie? Or Boliviana? I don't know if she can. Maybe she's hearing, but we can't see her. Okay, thank you, everyone. Karina, muchísimas gracias. You know, this is your reading, Karina, that you made for me right here. Your mastana that you gave me. This is for my Misha. This is the one I use every day that you made. Thank you.
Voy a hacer otro también.
Ay, qué bueno. Lindo, me encanta.
I want one.
Yeah.
I love the colors.
So nice, right?
Very beautiful.
Mm-hmm. Did you talk to the Capacheja Nyusta when you were weaving?
¿Le conoces a la Capacheja Nyusta?
No.
No. No, okay.
No, but she will.
Yeah. Yeah, she will. Beautiful. And do you weave these for Akuchi?
Akuchi.
make more of these so we can buy them for our offering bags. Akuchi. This is what we learned about this week. That you put your coca leaves in the Akuchi. The women use the Akuchi and the men use the Pukuchu. A little bag. So you always have a little carrying method, a little carrying pouch for your offerings to give to the nature beings. It's perfect. All right. Thank you so much, everybody. Thank you for coming. Thank you for being here. Thank you for your patience. And I'm so, so sorry that we were late in the start. Thank you.
Thank you very much, everyone.
Thank you so much.
Always a pleasure.
Very interesting.
Yes.
Great presentation, Karina. Fantastic.
Muy bonito, Karina.
Muchas gracias a ustedes. Espero que les haya gustado.
Mucho, mucho.
Y tener otra oportunidad más para hacer más exposiciones de mi cultura. Queros.
Oh, yeah.
I hope she will have more opportunity to make more presentations of her Quero culture.
Yes, you will. Yes.
Beautiful. Does she sell the mastanas? Like the one you have?
She does. And the school is buying weavings from each team. So we will make them available. Yeah. You know, so we're trying to do it evenly. So yes. Yes, perfect. Okay. Urpichai song kolai.
Chao, espero
verlos
en otra oportunidad.
Chao, chao.
Bye. Thank you so much.
Gracias a ustedes.
Aloha.
Aloha.
Aloha.